Dear friends around the globe who are watching and interested in the public health of India, particularly in corona crisis. You know well what's happening in India, and we thought of we are one of the best fighters in first phase of corona, but ultimately we landed with the worst phase where the death rate is highest and the maintenance of the public health is very poor. And the supplies of oxygen was very much, you know, not available, and people died of oxygen scarcity, and so our world's one of the worst misery was happened in India, and we are seeing the floating of the dead bodies in Ganga, Ganges, River Ganga, thousands of people, as the dead bodies, they are just flown to the shores of Ganga. Here, as a professional, as a medical practitioner, as a public activist, I would like to say few of the things. You know well what's happening in India. The earlier we had an excellent public health system, where it was very much initiated in the very much the days of independence itself. There was a Bhor committee which was very much drafted for the public health, and ultimately, as the Bhor committee is the basic manuscript. India evolved so many health plans, and you know very well all the public health systems were developed in the initial stages and given the highest priority to the rural health as well as infrastructure of the health. That is the only reason why India has got so many thousands and thousands of primary health care centers around India and in remote places also. We have got an Arogya Karyakarta who will visit the most remote places, and we know primary health center where the doctors will serve. This is happening since decades, but ultimately where we ended is we ultimately very much weakened the public health system. That resulted in when a crucial time came, our systems were not working. At least in this part we made these wonders, and we actually faced the situation. And the part which the success is there is only because of the earlier days, the importance we give to the public health structure. So here again I would like to say, the earlier governments, at least by the pressure of the people, we have got a long standing demand, you know well. The poorest countries also, their health budget categorization is not less than 6 to 7%, and it is in India. Since the independence, we never exceeded more than 3%, 4%. So much of the times it's 1.5. And particularly after BJP came into power, the war game is more important than the fight, the war against the disease. Ultimately, we landed with the greatest crisis, where in such a crisis time, we are listening to the poor, superstitious, unscientific things. So, these all things ultimately resulted in the great misery and the loss of human beings and our friends and all. That's the reason why I would like to tell you the ICMR, AMS, CCMB, all these people are involved, even nowadays DRDO is also involved. I would like to say there is no epidemiologist in India who is authenticated will be knowing about the epidemiology of coronavirus or whatever the health management crisis comes, there should be an epidemiologist. Around the globe, you know well, all the countries, when a management comes, it is the epidemiologist who deals. And you know, we always very frequently listening the name of Fauci, who was the director for the CDC of America. And he used to tell about the Indian condition also. And when an American epidemiologist tells about what's going to happen in India and what's next step supposed to take, but there is no epidemiologist authentically will tell in India. And never this government, particularly central government, taken any responsibility to draw the attention of the epidemiologist in the higher place. And despite that, what happened, despite our all the demands, ICMR, AMS, all these people, they are giving the confusing states, and particularly this is more added by WHO. You know very well, recently, plasma earlier days, we used to thought of it is ultimately rebirth to the corona patients, but ultimately it's proved it increases the corona variants. Now remdesivir will naturally will give another threat, and the other variants also come out of the remdesivir treatment, and we would like to discard the remdesivir treatment. And we in India, political pressure comes for remdesivir supply, and the chief ministers claim we got 5,000 vials, we got 6,000 vials, we pressured the government, we got it. This is the situation in India. So what I would like to tell is, initial days there will be confusion, but confusion should not be perpetuated as they like. It should not be organized. That's what I would like to draw the attention of my people who are concerned about India. And very much I would like to say, the things what was happened is okay, what happened is there. We live for that. But one option is there. India has got tremendous infrastructure till now because of the early and primary health care and the staff we got. But still, we have to recruit thousands and thousands of people, doctors, nurses, epidemiologists, as well as interventionists, and so many specialties you know well, pulmonologists, all these things. More than that, research also. You know well, when we have got the prestigious international institutes, Institute of Virology, Institute of Immunology, Institute for Central Research Institute for so many vaccines preparations and all these, you know, Kasauli and Pune were very popular. And they used to manufacture the vaccines and they give the guidelines also. Now they were reduced to the just research institutes. Now Serum Institute of India has become a star campaigner. And it is more popular than our central institutes. You know well. And the DRDO marketed, they have given this chance to manufacture to Reddy Laboratories. This 2DG, 2-deoxy glucose, whatever the substance is there, it is. This was given as a contract to develop and to sell it. The formula was given to Reddy Laboratories, where the pharmacological institutes in India, you know very well, IDPL and all, they used to do the wonders. Now we have reduced all these international institutes into just the old days, great golden temples. That's gone. So at least now the time is there for Modi, I request, to revive all the Indian top national institutes, their research activity and whatever the perspectives are there, has to be tapped. This is the time. And at least now he has to listen to the words of health personnel and all, because this is his ultimate. So I request central government not to play the politics in the local states and all. We are giving everything, PMK, we are giving everything, the local governments are not doing, this is not the question. When people are demanding a health emergency, where is the question of, you just see the things and you become a spectator. You have to involve. You have to involve. You have to give the guidelines. You have to threaten them. If the things are not taken, we will take entire the system into our hands. This is the threat we have to give. But the very unfortunate, the things are going in a political way rather than the administrative procedure. So I request central government to involve in all the states and take the highest activity. When you say center should be powerful, when you say center should be powerful in a crisis time, not to manage the state governments in politics, this is the time. So immediately I request epidemiologists to come, and particularly giving lot of importance to the private operators and all these people for vaccines has to be discarded. India has got enormous capacity to produce vaccines independently from public sector itself. When you are selling very much the profitable public sector to the others, it may not be possible to revive the earlier public sector which has got the great track record. But we have got a hope. It's our responsibility to request you. At this time, I request the Prime Minister of India to revive all the national systems and as well as public health system, and immediately appoint a powerful, very much a good administrative epidemiologist and epidemiological system also. Because this will be a guideline for the next, when WHO telling about it goes for 10 years. If it is real, 10 years we have to face it. So it's ultimately our responsibility. We have got already lost a precious time of more than 1 year. So at least now we have to come forward and propose the guidelines in a most scientific way and most effective way. This is my request. And a very unfortunate, when we are getting oxygen by warren aeroplanes and claiming it's a great activity, I can tell you very simply, the cost to import an oxygen cylinder from the foreign country by the vehicle itself is enough to erect an oxygen plant anywhere. So this is high time, at least whatever the pressure it has given, we have to take in a positive way that it has given us an insight and has got given us a chance to rebuild Indian health system. At least I hope Prime Minister of India will take this as a suggestion as well as a request by a concerned citizen, and I hope the things will change. And this is what I would like to make forward, this to entire the community who are concerned about the Indian public health system and people of India.